everyone, this is me Sadia here and I'm back with the bonus love reads. This reading is going to be for the sign of Sagittarius. So let's see what is coming up for Sagittarians for this reading. Topic of the reading is, are you on their mind? Whoever it is that you're dealing with, you really want to know, have you been on their mind? Yes or no? I will be adding oracle cards in this reading. I will also be adding messages from your person as well. So stay tuned and I will be doing this reading for four more signs. Pisces, Leo, Libra, and Scorpio. So yeah, since they got the most use for the last reads that I uploaded. So yeah, this one is going to be for Sagittarius. So let's see, Sagittarians, what is up with your person? Have you been on their mind? Are you on their mind? Let's find out. Before I dive into the read, let me remind you, it is a general read. It may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the signs and messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal reads, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also check the other services that I offer as well in the description box. So yeah, let's see. Are you on their mind? Whoever it is that you're dealing with, whoever it is that you want to know about, you can check this reading for them. So are you on their mind? Yes or no? Let's begin. Six of Swords, the Strength, Page of Cups, Five of Pentacles. Okay, the Emperor. And in the deck, we do have the King of Cups. I feel like, you know, this person really loves you, whoever it is that you're asking about, but at the same time, they are tired of the current situation that they have been having with you. I don't know what has been happening in this connection between the two of you. Maybe it has been on and off. Maybe it has been like, you know, troublesome. Maybe it had have a lot of turbulence in the connection between the two of you. Maybe it has been on and off. There is some sort of not so positive energy attached to the connection that you have with your person. This connection has, you know, like any other connection, maybe they have their, you know, it had been very up, you know, the vibration of this connection could have been very up and down. You know, maybe there has been, you know, the time where, you know, more time where you have fights, less time where you are having a smooth time forward. So maybe this is one of the blocks in this connection, because I feel like, you know, when it comes to your person's energy, they really look forward to have something stable in their love life. Because it seems like, you know, this person, whoever it is that you are dealing with, they are somebody who needs stability in their life to perform well in their whatever area they are working in. Maybe this person is somebody who is very much at a position in their life where they are responsible to, you know, major stuff. Maybe they are serving the government, maybe they are serving the army. They have to be mentally relaxed to perform their best. Somehow what has been happening in this connection is that this connection has been affecting your person in a negative way. They might have been having on and off with you, which has been affecting the connection, the mental capacity of your person as well. It seems like, you know, whenever they want to think about you, all they think about you, what they think is the negative part of the connection. They always have been thinking about that. You know, what didn't work well? They wanted it to be smooth, but what didn't work out is something which they have been having on their mind lately. They really have feelings for you, but at the same time, they are not happy with this connection. They are not happy. Even if you are with this person currently as well, I feel like, you know, this connection is not going where you want it to go with your person. Neither your person wanted to go this way. They feel that they are ready for a committed connection. They want a stable connection in their life, which can add to their mental, physical, emotional stability, so they could do their best in their work scenarios as well. Right now, the situation between the two of you is not so helpful for them to have in their life. I feel like, you know, this connection could have been having the rough patch, and I feel like, you know, this person, even if they miss you, they don't feel like taking any action in this situation. Now, if for those of you, you are in no communication with your person, and if your connection had an ending in the recent times, I feel like, you know, maybe if your person ended the connection because they were not ready for a committed relationship, maybe this time around they are thinking of a stable connection. And if that's what they were like not giving into, like, you know, if they were not the one who were ready to give into this connection seriously, this time around, it seems like, you know, their energies are changing towards their love life. They want that stable one connection, which they can, you know, which can add to their life. So in that situation, your person might be coming forward towards you, because you would be the one that they are going to think of when they're going to think of getting married, getting committed. And if, especially if they have been the one who was not ready to invest in a connection, then. So I feel like, you know, if you are, or if you have been in no communication, there is a strong possibility of your person coming towards you, leaving their mental, physical, emotional blocks towards you, towards committed relationship, and they will be coming forward. Let's see some more cards. Let's see what else is happening. Have you been on their mind lately? Wow, the Magician. Seven of Swords. They will be coming towards you. They are mentally, physically, emotionally prepared. I feel like, you know, for those of you who are in a relationship with this person, let's see, for them. If you are in no communication with this person, then this person is definitely going to give you what you want. But if you are in communication with this person, then this person is still having those issues with you. So I feel like, you know, to have the kind of life that you desire with your person, an ending is a must. If the ending has happened recently, then you are on the right track where your person is going to give you what you desire with them. If you have been trying to stick this connection together and, you know, trying your best to make them commit to you and stuff like that, there is a time apart coming between the two of you. I feel like, you know, for majority of you who are going to have something beautiful coming with your person are going to be the ones who are in no communication with your person currently, because your person is now ready to commit to get married. They will be choosing you to be their life partner. If you are still with this person, you really need to break free from this person. Why? Because there is a lot of toxicity when they think of you, think of this connection. So that needs to end there. Once it is ended, once you have pulled away, once they have pulled away, then they are going to look for love, find love for themselves. But then when they go out and about and they are going to see what kind of people are available out there, they're going to come back to you. So eventually, I do see you and your person coming back together. They are going to be thinking of you, but if and only if there is a time apart between the two of you. Otherwise, this person will try to run away from you as much as they can, because right now seems like, you know, they are not happy with the current vibe, especially if you are with this person. But yes, if you are not with this person, then they are going to look for you in every person out there, and then they're going to come back to you. So that's what I'm picking up. Let's see what else is happening here in this connection between the two of you. Let's see what else is the message from the divine. I feel like, you know, whoever it is that you're dealing with, this person is somebody who needs their space. Right now, maybe with you, they do have that kind of, you know, maybe you are somebody who wants them 24/7. They need their space. Now, if you chase this person is going to run away from you. You might have been chasing this person. You might have been, when I say chase, I don't mean like, you know, you are like, you know, literally chasing this person. It's more like, you know, you are not giving them the space that they need right now. You need to give them the space. Once you give them the space that they have been craving, asking for, they are going to don't like it. They are not going to like it. In fact, they're going to hate it when you give them the space. That is what is needed in this connection. If you can pull yourself away, even being with this person, trust me, the things will start changing for you. Because I feel like, you know, your person is somebody who's, you know, they are going to run away from you if you stay with them. But if you kind of, you know, don't give them too much of your time and energy, they are going to value you more. So I feel like, you know, that's something that you need to do right now if you are with this person. But if you are away from this person, they are definitely coming in with something stable to offer, something that they were not ready before. You are good enough. You really need to know that you are good enough. You really don't have to chase this person at all. Let this person come to you when they are ready. Then we do have, say you are all mine. Now this is them. Like, you know, they are going to want you when you are saying that I don't want you, you know, that's them. This person is going to be like, you know, oh, we have another card here. We have two cards. Wow. You make me feel important. So it seems like, you know, you have been chasing them. You make them feel important. But then this is something that pushes them away as well. They enjoy being the center of your attention. But at the same time, they hate it when you don't give them the space. So what you got to do is keep them hungry for your attention. That's the way to go about it. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you. They do have you on their mind when you are not with them. But yes, when you are with them, they're going to push you away. So that's your person. So yeah, I hope it was of help. If you are willing to purchase services from me, you can check the description box for further details on that. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye.